In this video, we'll once again compare TCP and UDP protocols, focusing on latency and throughput. While I was working on another benchmark, I discovered a few things we can improve in the previous test, and I decided to share them with you. But first, let's take a look at how TCP protocol works. First of all, the client and server needs to establish a connection, and this is done via three-way handshake. First, the sender sends a synchronized packet to the receiver, which indicates that the client wants to start a connection and provides a random sequence number that will be used later to transmit data. Then the receiver responds with a synchronized acknowledge packet, saying, "Got it. Here is my sequence number and I acknowledge yours." Finally, the sender replies with acknowledge packet, adds +1 to the sequence number and confirms. Cool, we sync up. Let's talk. We can use Wireshark, and for simplicity, we can listen on localhost and define a capture filter to only capture packets with port 8080 as either the source port or the target port. At this point, we don't really have any packets yet, so let me start the server and then send a JSON payload. Now we can see a TCP handshake. We have the syn, synack, and final ACK packets, indicating the establishment of the TCP connection. So I run my server on port 8080, but when you create a client, it will randomly get a port to create a TCP socket and connect to the server. You can also see that my server sends a JSON message to the client, and the client, after receiving the message, sends back an empty packet with only a header, indicating that it received the message. To run my tests, I use AWS, and for this test, I used M7A medium instance for each application involved in the test. To implement it, I used C++ and raw sockets to send and receive TCP and UDP messages. You can find the source code in my public GitHub repository. Let me start with exactly the same setup as in the previous test. We only have two stages. First, we start sending only 16,000 messages, and you can notice that UDP latency is lower as expected, because UDP does not require a connection or acknowledgement of received data. In the second stage, we try to send as much data as we can using TCP and UDP, and you can notice that TCP, due to better congestion control, can deliver higher throughput than UDP. It's important to take a note of the final values. TCP can achieve around 620,000 messages per second, while UDP can only handle 310,000. However, at maximum load, you can also notice that the difference in latency increases, and UDP clearly performs better when you need lower latency, whereas TCP excels when you prioritize throughput and reliability. Well, I was assuming when you use CMake to build a project, by default it would produce optimized production-ready binary. But I was wrong. For the next stage of the test, let me recompile exactly the same source code using release mode. Once again, I have the same two stages. In the first stage, it's pretty much the same. You might see slightly less CPU usage, but nothing significant. Now, in the second stage, TCP throughput increased to 1 million messages per second, but surprisingly, UDP did not gain more throughput. Instead, you can see lower latency. So compiling and building applications in release mode still improves both applications. It's a silly mistake and there is no excuse for me, but it demonstrates how much more performance you can achieve by properly compiling your applications. The final improvement actually relates to monitoring. I knew that instrumenting your application with metrics would reduce performance, but I had never actually measured it before. So I used Prometheus histogram to measure latency for UDP and TCP messages sent and received by the clients. Many of you do the same in production, but when you measure something like raw TCP or UDP packets, those measurements can affect your performance. So in the next test, I keep using Prometheus counter to calculate the rate of messages we receive, but I disable histogram, so you won't see latency in the final test. This is the first stage. Now, in the second stage, you can see that TCP reached 1,100,000 messages per second, which is 10% more than in the previous test, and the same applies to UDP. Now we get around 420,000 messages per second. This demonstrates that simply instrumenting high-performance applications can easily reduce your performance by 10% or more. So be very careful. Every function call and measurement can and will reduce performance of your application. This is especially important in trading systems, where every microsecond counts. In the next video, I'll compare WebSockets and HTTP or REST API. But for now, you can take a look at my other benchmarks between databases, caches, and different languages.